Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
All righty, thank you. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you with us. As you know, we have a studio audience divided into three sections, each one rooting like mad for our celebrity couples. They are the blue section, the banana section, and the red section. And let's meet the couples they're going to be rooting for. On my left, winning money for the blue section, will be Betty White and her husband, Allen Ludden. It's nice to have you both with us today. Alan, you've got blue on, oddly enough, and you're in the blue section. That's perfect, isn't it?
Yeah, that worked out pretty well. I didn't even know.
Does that mean you're going to win a lot of money for them today?
Naturally.
Remember, gang, you heard it here. He said it, right? Okay. We'll hold him responsible for that. If all the girls you ever had a romantic relationship with were herded into one room, would you know them all by name? If all the girls you ever had a romantic relationship with were herded into one room, would you know them all by name? Think about that, fellas, and we'll come back for your answer in a moment. Would you know them by face is the question, I think. Betty, what's Alan going to say?
Well, in the first place, it'd be a little hard to get them all in one room. In the second place, yes, I think he might not remember their names. He'd remember their measurements, but I'm not sure he'd... I think he wouldn't.
He'd say no.
Yes.
He wouldn't. All right, let's bring him on and find out. What's the answer, Alan? If there they all are, herded into one room, you're going to know them by name?
Well, it's not that there are so many. It's just that I'm so bad with names. No, I wouldn't. What did she say?
You say, what did she say? That's Betty. You mean, what did Betty say?
What's her name?
He is bad with names, you know?
Yes, he's just terrible.
She agreed with you, and you're right, and you have a share of the pot, Alan.
Great.
Thank you. The new skin-tight plastic bathing trunks for men are known to the trade as stuffies. If someone...
What trade?
I don't know. If someone gave you a pair of stuffies as a present, would you wear them to a public beach? Let me ask it again now. The new skin-tight elastic bathing trunks for men are known to the trade as stuffies. If someone gave you a pair of stuffies as a present, would you wear them to a public beach?
Well, if you think I want to do anything with that stuffy thing, there are those who think Alan's the stuffiest, and that's not true, believe me. I'll tell you, I think if he wore them, he probably would wear them to the beach, but he'd put his knickers on over them. No, I don't think. I really don't think he would.
You don't, huh? Really?
Really.
Okay, let's bring him on and find out. Alan, would you wear your stuffies to a public beach?
Did you say they were made out of elastic?
Yes, I said skin-tight elastic bathing trunks.
Oh, I thought you said skin-tight plastic bathing trunks.
I might have. I don't know.
Elastic. Now, what would she think I... My body's not my best thing. I don't know. I wouldn't wear them.
That's what she said. You're right. Men. A married couple invites the two of you for a weekend at their new rustic cabin.
Oh.
You arrive to find that only one big bed has been delivered.
Oh.
Listen now, to Papa Bear over here.
Now you have three choices.
Yeah.
Would you accept their offer to sleep in the bed while they sleep on the floor? Insist that they sleep in the bed while you sleep on the floor? Or would you all agree that you all four sleep comfortably in the bed together?
Bert?
That is the question,
Bert?
And those are the choices. What, Pat?
There's four choices, but I don't want to go into it now.
The three that we're going to deal with here is that you sleep on the floor, they sleep on the floor, you all sleep in the same big bed together. Oh. Think about that, gentlemen, and come back to us in a minute, will you? Okay, Betty, how about Alan? What's he going to say?
Can you imagine how much sand would be left in that bed the next morning? No, I tell you, I know how I'd feel, and I think on a situation like that, it'd be kind of fun to all four try it together.
Sleep in the big bed together. You think Alan's going to think the same way?
I think so.
You think so?
What do I know?
Okay, let's...
She has a lot of...
Let's not give it away now. Let's bring on Allen. All right, Allen, what do you do about four people in one big bed there? How are you going to handle that?
I guess I'm just as square as Carson says I am. I think probably Betty and I would sleep on the floor and they'd sleep in the...
Tell them what you said, Betty.
Has this ever happened before?
Betty, would you like to tell your husband what you said?
I just said it would be kind of fun. It's a festive little atmosphere.
And... little devil.
Would you go all the way with the four?
No, that wasn't the question.
I don't know what you're going to do. I'm going to go to sleep.
Since when?
Never. I'm sorry, Allen. We have... that wasn't the question at all. We have no score there. I'm sorry, Allen. Thank
what
you.
Did she say?
She said you'd all sleep in the bed together.
Well, I'd be okay.
Yeah.
It's a little late.
But that isn't what you said, so I'm sorry. No score. Thanks, Allen.
Okay, I have a tattletale quickie. I am now going to ask the gentleman this question. Do not give me the answer until I ask for it. Here it is, fellas. Do you think, in general, if a wife wants her husband to wear a wedding ring, he should do it? Do you think, in general now, not specifically about you folks, but in general, if a wife wants a man to wear a wedding ring, should he wear it? Think about that, fellas, and we'll be back to you in just a second. Okay, Betty, how about Allen? Do you think he will think that a man should do that?
I've lost my confidence. Sure, why not?
No.
Sure, yeah.
You think?
Yes, to anything, Bert. You bet. Whatever you want, I think
now, Betty,
so.
I want you to think about this carefully.
I'm thinking about it carefully. I'm with you, Bert. You bet.
You don't want to change your mind?
No. Yes, you bet.
Yes, the man, he should do so. Okay, let's bring on Allen. Okay, Allen, what is the answer to that?
I think he should wear it because he wants to, but if she wants to, I see no reason for his not doing it, so I think he should.
That's right. You were right, sir. You had us all scared there for a minute, but you came through and you were right. Absolutely. Let's see a score up there. Okay, that makes it official. Thank you, Allen. Same question, a birthday you will never forget. Betty, you are up.
Well, again, it was a surprise party that I'll never forget. It was a rather momentous birthday, and he thought it was kind of a momentous birthday before a momentous birthday. And he thought, well, this one she won't expect at the surprise party. And he made it so casual that I thought I was just going to have dinner with my mother and my husband, and I were just going to a restaurant. That poor fellow even went out and bought me an outfit to wear and casually had to con me into wearing it. And I got to the place, and they conned me upstairs with a whole long story, which I won't go into. And... all our good friends were there. It was. I kept running into two people at a time until it was a whole beautiful thing.
Oh.
It was the most complete surprise I've ever had.
Okay.
And only four of them got drunk and fell overboard. But, you know, otherwise...
Funny, and you weren't even on the water.
No. So
I wonder how they did that. Okay, what are you going to use as a clue, Betty? One or two words.
Restaurant. Okay.
Restaurant. One word.
I'll take it from you, babe.
All right, that's what your section wants. Let's bring on the fellas. Gentlemen,
yes.
We have another question and we have another clue. Actually, we have the same question, a birthday you will never forget. And the clue is restaurant. Ooh, that's close. Who was first? Allen was first. All right, Allen, tell us about that one.
Well, I thought a while ago she was going to press the buzzer. I gave her a surprise party, too. It wasn't on a boat. It was at Chasen's restaurant here in Los Angeles, and I fooled her pretty good, and she walked in. My only concern about the whole thing was that since it was a surprise, I wanted to be darn sure she had on something that she'd be pleased to be seen in. So I not only had to get her a party, I had to get her a new dress.
Men, suppose there's a mirror in the room. Which of you is more apt to steal a look at yourself, you or your wife? Suppose there's a mirror in the room. Which of you is more apt to steal a look at yourself, you or your wife? Think that over, fellas. Very revealing. We'll be back to you in just a moment. Okay.
Is he gone?
Yes, he's
gone. Are we alone?
He's definitely gone.
I thought he'd never leave. No contest. Allen cannot resist a mirror. Even if the water gets a little still, he just has to. Allen would look in the mirror.
You will say he will be the one.
He will be the first.
Who cannot resist.
And the last.
Stealing a look at himself in the mirror first.
And in the middle.
Okay. Let's bring on Allen. Okay, Alan. You know the question, sir. Which of you is more apt to steal a look at yourself in that mirror?
Well, I'm very insecure. I am.
That's what you said, $400. Thank you, Alan. Fellas, in your bachelor days, which turned you on the most in your bachelor days? Short skirts, tight slacks, or plunging necklines?
Oh, my.
In your bachelor days, I'm making that definite. Which turned you on the most? Short skirts, tight slacks, or plunging necklines? We'll get back to you in just a moment.
I know. It's a shoe
in. In his bachelor days, which one of those three turned Alan on the most, Betty, do you think?
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
I tell you, Alan has had so few bachelor days. He was married for years and years and years to a lovely lady who has since passed away, and then he's been married to me, so he hasn't really had a lot of time on his own. But on his free time in between, I'd say short skirts.
Short skirts.
I would say.
Let's bring on Alan and see. Alan, which one of those three turns you on the most in your bachelor days, that is?
I've been married all my life, so it's no different. I haven't changed. That's a terrible choice.
Really?
I think, with a very slight difference, I like the plunging neckline.
What did she say?
What did you say? That. Tell them what you said, Betty.
Well, I said, from just judging by your eyeballs, I would say short skirt.
Well, I wouldn't touch that. You go ahead.
No, you better not touch it. Anyway, thank you, Alan. There's no score there.
A story about bedtime.
Betty.
You are up, Betty. Let's hear that story.
I think that was more a reflex action than anything else. Well, I tell you, once in a while I have my hair done. Not necessarily today, but once in a while. And on the night that I have my hair done, I don't want him to see me with this bonnet that I wear, but I wait till we turn out the light, and then I just in one motion I turn the light out and I roll over and put my head on his shoulder. We always start that way. To go to sleep. As I turn the light out, I slip this bonnet on and I'm over. And he never can figure out how I get it on from the time I turn the light out here till I get on his shoulder.
Okay, so now we need a clue for that.
You had to be there. Or were you? Bonnet. Bonnet.
Bonnet. Okay.
Let's bring on the fellas, shall we? Gentlemen, we have another question and another clue. Here is the question first. A story about bedtime. And the clue is... bonnet.
Alan, you're up, sir.
Tell us that story, Alan.
I gotta tell you, Betty has many talents, but among them is being a great master of sleight of hand. When she goes to the beauty parlor, the day she goes to the beauty parlor, she doesn't want to get her hair messed up while she sleeps. On the other hand, she doesn't want me to see her in that thing she puts on while she sleeps to cover up her hair. And I promise you, I have never seen it, because in the time that it takes her to reach over and turn on that light beside her, she can put that hat on and be back in my arms, and I don't know till I feel it that she's got it on.
Okay. Thank you, Alan.
Here we are. We're back with question number two, and this is it. If you're wondering what I have in my hand, it is the Boy Scout handbook.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that.
And this is the question, fellas. The ladies have the handbook in front of them out here.
I have a Boy Scout as well.
This is the Boy Scout handbook. Each of you has a copy open to the Boy Scout law.
Yeah.
Let me read it. A scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent. Now, fellas, we know you are all of these, but which one applies to you most?
Oh, that's terrible.
Can you hear that now?
I could tell you which one is the least.
You are. A scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent. Which one applies to you most? We'll come back to find out in just a moment. Signing off, gentlemen. Betty, what's Alan going to say?
I don't know what he's going to say. That's the tip off, because he is all those things. And
how about clean? Is he clean?
I know. Well, on a good day. Yes, he's all those things. I know what I would say, fool that I am. And he just might say it, too. I'm going to say that he is, above all, trustworthy.
Trustworthy. Now, what is the definition?
Isn't he?
Well, I don't know.
He is not trustworthy.
He'll be trustworthy if he wins this one, he will. What does trustworthy mean, do you think?
I think when he says he's going to do something, that you can stake your life on it. And he's honest above all things. And I would rather depend on him than anybody. And I do.
So you'll go with trustworthy.
Trustworthy.
Let's bring him on. Allen, you've had a little bit of time now. Which one of these do you think applies to you most?
Which one do I think that Betty thinks I will think applies to me most?
There's the rub.
Kind.
I think you are kind.
What did she say?
You're kind of wrong on that one.
He is that too.
Tell him what you said, Betty.
I said, idiot that I am, that you're trustworthy.
I started to say that.
Well, why didn't you? You could have said it.
Now, don't fight. That's not on the list here. I'm sorry, you don't have a share of that, Allen, but you'll be kind about it, I know.
Yeah, but not generous.
A humdinger of an argument. Betty! You were there, Betty.
We have those a lot, I'm sorry to say, but it's really usually, well, about politics, or it's about, we have different views on how to raise kids, and... One corker of an argument that we had, I got a little testy, just a little put out, and I threw my car keys at the bedroom door, and there's a scar left in that door that won't heal.
You threw your car keys?
I threw my car keys right at the door.
Did you think it was the garage at the time? Or?
No, I didn't realize the door was closed. The keys went through the door, but the door was closed.
You were aiming at Allen.
Yes.
All right, we need a one or two word clue that Allen might recognize.
Keys.
Keys, it has to be. Okay. Let's bring on the fellas, shall we? Gentlemen, we have asked a question and we have a clue. Here is the question first.
Okay.
A humdinger of an argument. And here is the clue. Keys. Keys. All right, Chuck, tell us about that, if you will.
Yeah, we always have an argument over keys, and the reason is that I can never find my keys. I put my keys down, and for some reason, she's always putting them away somewhere. Uh-huh. I can never find them, and so we constantly really have battles over, Joanne, where are my keys?
Yes.
And
that's fascinating.
Hello?
Chuck.
Hello? Anyone there?
That isn't what Joanne said. Allen, where were you on that one?
Quit
thinking, darling.
No. I thought it was me, but it's more doors open for dogs. But I do get messed up with the keys, too.
Do you remember that particular...
Yeah.
I'm sorry. You didn't remember.
We've never had a serious argument. I had to... Sorry.
We have.
Betty's just made a face of incredulity. Is that a word? I think it is. Anyway, she made a face when you said that. She doesn't believe that. Anyway, I'm sorry. No score, Allen.
I'm sorry, Allen.
Which do you find more provocative? Looking at nude pictures of girls or reading sexy books? Now, this is rather a hypothetical question, of course. Which do you find more provocative? Looking at pictures of nude girls or reading sexy books. Go away and think about that, fellas.
Oh, you're bad.
I only read them, my dear. It's certainly a hypothetical question. We understand that. But, I mean, which do you think that Allen would find more provocative? Would he ever be in the market?
I'm trying to think of what's on his nightstand that he's reading. Raggedy Ann and Andy in the Deep Dark Forest. Reading sexy books.
Reading sexy books, yes. Would be more provocative as far as that. Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, okay. Bunch of guys up there going, yeah. Okay, bring on Allen, please. Allen, which would you find? Oh, it's been deep thought. Which would you find
Well, that's
more...
not just a light question. That's a very heavy thing you've asked me to think about.
That's true.
This is a very heavy show, I gotta tell you.
Oh, yes.
Very
yes.
profound.
Yes.
Books.
That's what you said. Yeah.
You're absolutely
right.
We're
on our way. This is our day.
This is it, huh? Okay, guys. Do you ever find yourself envying the younger generation's so-called sexual freedoms, thinking you might have missed something when you were younger? Do you ever find yourself envying the younger generation's so-called sexual freedoms, thinking you might have missed something? You know, I've never read a question with the card in my left hand. I can't do it.
You can't read left-handed.
No, I can't read left-handed. Now, this way I can read it just fine. Oh, now, do you ever find yourself envying the younger generation's so-called sexual freedoms, thinking you might have missed something when you were younger? Go away and think about it, fellas, and we'll come back. It's much easier that way. Betty, how about Allen? What's he going to say?
Well, Allen likes the younger generation very much, and he likes their freedoms. But I really have heard him sound off on the subject often enough that he really feels that they gain a lot of sexual freedom, but they lose some of some of the fun with it. It's like playing handball with no backboard. If you have too much freedom, there's nothing to know what's freedom and what isn't. I think no.
No, he's going to say...
I could have said no in the first place. It would have been simpler,
no,
right?
No, you qualified it beautifully. You're going to say that he's going to say no.
No. Yes, I mean, yes, I'm going to say he's going to say
yes,
no.
Yes, he's going to say no.
Right,
oh,
yes.
We could go around like this for a long time, couldn't we? Okay, no is the answer. Let's bring him on. Allen, do you ever feel that you missed something when you were younger?
That's all. That never... Just, are you ready, gang? We're on the upswing. I am so sure we're going to win on this because I got to tell you something.
Would you like me to repeat the question?
I didn't miss anything. I don't ever envy it.
That's what the lady said. All right.
At halftime, we will change places. Ladies to the rear. Fellas, come on out here. Unbelievable. While we are changing places, we're going to break away for just a moment. Please come back for the second half of Tattletales, okay? Okay, we're back. We've changed places. I have the fellas out here with me. And the ladies in the back, in case you don't know the score, ladies, or if you've forgotten,
story
fellas, maybe you don't know either. Betty and Allen have 50, and the red and yellow section have 125 apiece. Ready to go?
Yeah.
Here's
oh.
the first question worth $150. Girls, think back. Did you ever write any love letters you wish you hadn't written? Did you ever write any love letters that you wish you hadn't written? Think about that, and we'll come back in a moment. Bye, girls. So it's so much fun when I ask the questions. I see their faces and you can't. I know a lot already. Allen, what about Betty? What's she going to say?
See, she's written a lot of love letters, but she's so pleased with them, you know. She's so sentimental and so romantic. I would think, though, if she hasn't, she ought to be ashamed. I think I'd be terribly disappointed in her if she hasn't written some that she's ashamed, sorry about. So I'm going to say yes, she has.
Yes, she has. All right, let's bring her on and find out. Betty, have you ever written any love letters you kind of wish you hadn't?
Well, it's easy to say that after the fact, but no, I haven't, because at the time I met him.
Guess what Allen said?
Boo.
The audience goes, oh.
We're not doing too well in the blues.
But finish
what
you were
saying.
We had
a chance to win, but we blew it. No, that's not what I meant. No, actually, I met them at the time, so how can you, regret them afterwards? So I went to court. It was a very small... I don't think so. I never put anything in writing that I ever want to be haunted with.
I understand. Okay. But unfortunately, you didn't say what
that.
He said. Thanks, Betty.
Suppose your husband's new secretary says to you, you know, your husband is the sexiest man I ever met. Would you be pleased to hear it or a little irritated by it? Just suppose your husband's new secretary says to you, you know, your husband is the sexiest man I ever met. Would you be pleased to hear it, or would you be irritated? Think about that, ladies. We shall come back to you in a moment and find out. How would Betty react to your new secretary saying...
Well, I don't know how she would, but I know how she should.
How should she react?
And she better do it the way she should.
Yes.
And I think she will, because she usually does. No, I can't even say that.
Give us a break, will you?
All right. She'll be pleased with it, for heaven's sakes.
She would be,
as any good
huh?
red-blooded woman should be.
Oh, really? See, it doesn't say...
It doesn't say on my card what that secretary looks like. Wouldn't it be interesting if I had said...
Well, she'd trust some good old square Allen.
Oh, she
know,
does, yeah. Huh? I've heard that before, my friend. Okay, you say that she will say that she would be pleased to hear it.
She'd be more pleased than displeased.
You don't confuse me now. She's, it says here that you think she will say she'd be pleased to hear it.
And if she doesn't say that, boo, okay. Everybody
All
in
right.
the blue section.
All right, here we go. Let's bring her on. Okay, Betty, a correct answer is worth $100, and you can use it at this point now. So what is your answer? Would you be pleased to hear that or irritated?
Well, Alan's such a really a great guy, and I feel so kind of secure with him that if I heard that, I would be so irritated. I would.
They're turning hostile out here,
I
Betty.
I'm sorry.
Sorry about that.
Betty.
You, Alan.
I thought you'd be pleased.
I'd be surprised, and then I'd be irritated.
Well, that's what I mean, for heaven's sakes. A vote of confidence a guy my age needs it.
Sorry, Betty. No score under there.
A guy your age needs a new secretary.
Well, you get stuck in an automatic elevator between floors. It begins to get hot and uncomfortable.
I'll say.
Hard to breathe, too. You're alone, except for one man. Now, which would you prefer to be stuck? No, let me rephrase that. Now, which would you prefer to be stuck? This?
Why don't you just take another one?
Oh, no, I'm going to get out of this so gracefully, you're not going to believe it. Now, which would you prefer to be stuck with this? I don't believe this. I can't.
Winning money for the red team.
Here comes the third time, gang. Don't pick on me. I'm new at this. Now. Here we go. Now, which would you prefer, to be stuck this way with Burt Reynolds several hours or with an elevator repairman who could get you out in a few minutes? I think I deserve a hand for reading it right. Do you understand the question now? Which would you prefer, to be stuck with Burt Reynolds for several hours or an elevator repairman who could get you out in a few minutes? Think about it, ladies, but not too hard. And we'll come back to you in just a moment.
It's a problem. It's a real problem. Betty and Dinah are such good friends. Not that anything would happen if she were in the elevator for 4 or 5 hours with Burt. I don't know. And she doesn't have claustrophobia very much, and she and Bert would have a lot to talk about because they both love animals. But probably what she'd rather do is see Bert later and get out as soon as she could. So I'll say, but I'm not too sure about this, gang. I'll say the repairman, but hold your hats.
The red section man. Okay, you say the repairman. Let's bring on Betty. Okay, Betty, what would you rather do, several hours with Bert or the repairman?
I have a good reason for wanting the repairman. I mean, wanting to be in there with him.
You are absolutely right. That is what Alan said, and we'd love to hear the reason.
Well, Dinah is a great and dear friend, and while Dinah knows that all we would make for hours is jokes, I just wouldn't want to take a chance.
No, I understand. Name something you've always wanted. Name something that you have always wanted. Okay? Think about that, and we'll come back and find out what it is in a moment. Alan, what's Betty going to say?
Some kind of animal. I've been sitting here racking my brain. What kind of animal has she always wanted that she hasn't had?
Well, she turned them down in the first question, so...
The animals? Now, one thing for Reynolds is okay, but that... I'm going to say... Because she always wants one, and I'm going to say a Pekingese puppy, but I'll tell you what, it's going to be an animal, whatever it is, but I'm going to say a Pekingese puppy.
Okay, you have a lot of dogs now, don't you?
Yeah.
You have a bunch of dogs and stuff.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
I know Betty's very active.
Maybe I should say her own zoo.
All right, now we have to match, so you're going to say a Pekingese puppy.
Yeah. I bet you'll say my own zoo.
My own zoo.
Let's, yeah. Now, you think that's better than
the Pekingese puppy? The red section is getting hostile.
Pekingese puppy.
Pekingese puppy. Okay.
Very decisive these days. There
I'm a Libra. I'm a pure Libra.
Okay. Could I offer one?
No, it's going. You're not supposed to do that. He has to do it by himself. Okay, let's bring her on. Betty, what's something you always wanted?
Great, marvelous, thick, curly hair.
Close.
close.
Great harmless thick curly hair.
Not on me. Oh. She wants it on her.
No, not on you. Wants,
but that's not... I swore it'd be some kind of animal, Mike.
Well?
An animal with thick curly hair.
I'm sorry.
Bert Reynolds.
What's wrong with Scoey Mitchell?
Nothing.
All right.
I'm going to give you a choice of three compliments. Which would you most like to hear? A man says, "You're one of the most attractive women I've ever met." A woman says, "You're the best friend any woman could have." Or a child says, "I wish all mommies could be like you." Let me say it again for you. Which one of those compliments would you most like to hear? A man says, "You're one of the most attractive women I've ever met." A woman says, "You're the best friend any woman could have." Or a child says, "I wish all mommies could be like you." Go away and think about it, ladies. We'll come back to you in just a moment. All right, Alan. Which one of those do you think Betty would most like to hear?
Well, now, if you had something about what a dog says, there'd be no choice. But now, between children, women, and men, I'll go with the man. She'll say she'd prefer the compliment from the man.
Okay, she'd like to hear that one. All right, let's bring on Betty. Betty, which one of those three compliments would you like to hear?
Oh, I'm afraid there's just no contest. I like boys best. I think a man should say...
That's a good answer for $100. No contest at all, huh? You know, Alan said the one category we didn't have here was a dog.
Well, that would be first if they did say that.
Why is that? Do you have a dog you talk to a lot?
I have several I talk to. I talk to all kinds of animals.
Right. She talks to anything with a leg in each corner.
Yeah.
All right, thank you, Betty.
Not as often.
Okay. Go. Ladies, it's addressed to you. Do you ever buy things you don't really need just because they're a bargain? Do you ever buy things you don't really need just because they're a bargain? Think about that one carefully. And we'll come back for your answers in a moment. I guess now the setup, of course, is, Alan, that Betty's in a store. Maybe there's a terrific sale going on.
Yeah.
Can she resist a real bargain even though she doesn't really need it?
Well, if you'd have stopped before the bargain, does she buy things she doesn't need? Yes, she buys things she doesn't need. But she's not a big bargain hunter. Now, I don't know what she's going to say. After the last time, I blew it by changing in the middle. So I'm going to stick with what my initial impression is. Betty, not being a bargain hunter, I would say no. She does not buy things she doesn't need. Oh, I know.
See, there they go.
It's just terrible to be a Libra.
What was that?
Now you know why we're blue. Look at our score.
It says, now you know why we're blue. Look at our score. Do you want him to change his mind? You want to go with that, gang?
I tell you, she doesn't. She's not a big bargain hunter, honestly.
All right. Well, you're going to say no, then.
I'm going to say no.
Well, let's stick with it, then, Alan. Right. Let's go. Let's bring her on.
Now watch her ace me again.
Okay, Betty, what's the answer now, dear? Do you ever buy things you don't really need just because they're a bargain?
I buy things I don't really need whether they're a bargain or not. Yes, I'm afraid I do.
He said that. Exactly what he said. But he said the other answer, unfortunately.
I said, you don't...
Moving right along, folks. You can't get out of it. Thank you. It's no score there, Betty, but nice try, and thank you very much.
Same question. A story connected with an animal.
Now, I gotta tell you, gang, I could tell you 15 stories connected with an animal about this wife I'm married to, this lady I'm married to. But I'll pick the one. At one point in our lives, we lived in Westchester. And we used to go riding over the Sleepy Hollow Country Club. And driving back, we would go by the Rockefeller farm, and there were Black Angus cattle. And Betty, the second time we drove by, said, and I thought she was kidding, she said, "You never let me talk to these cattle." So the third time we were by, she said, "You still never let me talk to these cattle."
Uh-huh.
Finally, I stopped the car, and she walked up to the fence, and I promise you, there were no Black Angus cattle at that fence, but she started talking to one about 50 feet away. In about 10 minutes, she had 200 Black Angus cattle lined up at that fence, and she was talking to all of them. I promise it's a true story. Now, what am I going to use as a clue?
Gossiping over the back fence with the ladies. Huh?
All right.
We need
now,
a one or
if
two
he can
clues,
use Dane, I can use Angus, right?
Can he use Angus? Angus cattle.
How about bull sage?
Yes, the answer is yes, you may.
All right.
Bill had a great line. How about bull session?
Bull session?
What was that, Bill?
I think a good clue is bull session. I know the story you tell.
It's two words, if you'll forgive the expression. All right.
It's two
words.
We'll
go with Angus, and if she doesn't get it, it's the end.
She's going to be feverishly thinking of somebody named Angus back there. Okay, let's bring on the ladies. Ladies, we have asked another question. It is, in fact, the same question. A story connected with an animal. We have a clue. It is this. Angus. A story connected with an Angus. All right, Betty, tell us that story.
Well, I'm an animal freak, as you know, about anything. And before Alan realized that, when we first were starting to walk out together.
Walk out together.
we were driving one day, and I happened to mention that I had never petted a cow, and I loved cows, and we passed this field of Angus bulls, and I didn't know the difference, you see, between a bull and a cow.
The heck she did.
So I went over to the fence, and I guess I called them, and pretty soon, because they knew that I guess the vibrations were right, they began to gather. Pretty soon I had a whole bunch of Angus.
That's what the man said, the $100.
That's a I knew she was a little weird from then on.
I talked to the cows. Yeah. Ladies, back in the 40s, college kids swallowed live goldfish. The latest fad is streaking.
Hello? Yes.
If you were being initiated into a sorority, which would you rather do?
Oh, no.
Swallow a goldfish or streak? That is a question. If you were being initiated into a sorority, which would you rather do? Swallow a goldfish or streak? We'll be back to you in a moment, ladies. Okay. Yes. Now we'll find out, won't we? Ellen, how about Betty? Which would she rather do if she were being initiated?
Well, she's an animal freak. She says that. So swallowing a goldfish would mean killing a live animal, right?
Mm-hmm.
But she's also relatively modest. But I think she'd rather streak.
She's careful when the mother's around. That's what
streak.
He says streak. Let's see.
I don't know what she's going to say.
Well, we'll find out right now. Hold on a second. Let's bring on Betty. Betty?
Yes. No.
You look a little perplexed there.
I am.
All right. Now, which one of those would you prefer to do if you were being initiated?
There's just no way out of this one. I tell you, you're not going to be able to bear this answer. I'd streak.
That's what he said. Absolutely $100 for the bare facts there. We got it, didn't we? Thank you, Betty.
First kiss. Alan.
All right, I tell you what, it's a very simple thing if she'll just clear her head and remember it. Our first kiss was literally in a play. We were doing Critics' Choice. She was going with somebody else pretty heavily. And the first kiss I ever remember, I hope it's the one she remembers, was play, and it was Critics' Choice, and I think I'll say Dennett. No, I can't use a proper name, can I?
No, I can't. It has to be one or two word clue.
On stage. I'll just say stage. On stage. It was on stage.
You want a two word on stage?
No,
or
just
one word?
Stage.
Just stage. One word clue worth $100.
Wait, she might get mixed up with stage there. Play, I think play's better. Let's say play.
Play.
Then she thinks a play kiss.
Yeah.
Stage.
It's only a half-hour show, Alan.
Why don't you just leave her, Alan? You're in a lot of trouble, so...
Stock! What about summer stock? Would that do a stock?
Stock?
Stock would do it. Stock.
Yeah, kiss the horse.
Yeah, that's the thing. Kiss the horse.
They're all nodding their heads. Yes,
stock. Stock.
Oh, you want to go with stock?
Stock.
All right, stock.
I don't like what you're talking about. Right.
That sounds like your cow story again. All right.
God knows what we're going to get, kids.
All right, let's bring on the ladies. Everybody, ladies.
Yes.
We have a question and we have a clue. Here is the question first.
The clue.
It is the same question. First kiss. And here is the clue.
stop.
About that. Well, he started to kiss me and I said, stop. No, it wasn't that at all. No, what it was, we were in the car and we had been kind of friendly with each other, and all of a sudden he pulled up with his stop signal and he kissed me, and I think we missed four lights, but it was just lovely. Oh, that was Allen, wasn't it?
That's a very interesting story.
She misunderstood the clue.
I think you misunderstood the word. I said stuck.
Stuck? I thought you said stop.
No, I said S-T-O-C-K, stuck. And I'm sorry, that's not the answer that we have.
The first time he kissed me, I was stuck with him.
O-C-K,
wrong again.
The story, tell her what you said.
I told him that the first time I kissed you, and I was using it kind of euphemistically, was in summer stock. At Dennis Mass. Is that wrong, Betty?
I was so hung up at this stoplight, which was a couple of months before that, if you remember. I don't mean to bring up these problems on the
show. No, the stoplight was after summer stock,
well,
Betty.
Well, anyway, it wasn't.
Yes, it probably was, but we haven't got time to argue about it now, gang.
Girls, when one of you is telling a story, which of you is more likely to interrupt and say, oh, that isn't quite right, dear. It happened this way. Now, don't make a sound, girls. Don't give us any indication of your answer. When one of you is telling a story, which of you is more likely to interrupt and say, that isn't quite right, dear. It happened this way. Think about that, ladies. We'll come back in a moment. Oh, now, that's a wonderful situation that happens to all of us all the time. What's Betty going to say, Alan?
If anything breaks us up, it's going to be the fact that I'm always doing that.
You interrupt her, do you?
I don't necessarily understand sometimes the joke she's going for.
Uh-huh.
And I have been known to blow the joke.
Jumping in there.
Yes.
And
so let's say, no question, kids, we're in. She's going to say, I am.
Yeah. Okay.
But I've said that before this week.
Yes, the blue section has heard that before.
Yeah.
All right, let's go. She's going to say you.
Yes.
Let's bring her on. Now, Betty, which
now,
one?
Now, Bert.
One of you is telling a story. One of you is going to jump in and say, no, that's not quite right. Here, who is the one that jumps in and does that the most?
I don't even want to play this game. You know that. In spite of hating to be interrupted, I'm afraid I'm guiltiest. I'm not guiltiest.
No, he's the one who's most skillful.
Truth is not a bomb.
He was so positive, Betty. He said, gang, we're in. This is for sure. That's not the way it is, huh, Betty?
Betty!
What, Alan?
Give it to her, Alan.
Don't yell at me.
Who are you? You didn't mean to say what you just said, do you?
I did, because I'm honest. If I'm nothing else, I may be a bore, but I'm honest.
You'll never be boring, but you're wrong, Betty.
Wrong, too, I am.
Honest.
Sorry, and built like a little...
That's not what the man said. He said it was himself, Betty. Jill, I don't want to in any way put you under pressure, but no one has gotten this right yet. So $300 is riding on this. Let me repeat the question. When one of you is telling a story, which of you is more likely to interrupt and say, that isn't quite right, dear, it happened this way?
Joe. Is that right? No?
All right, that means nobody gets to that money.
You do too! Yes, you do!
That's not what he said, darling, I'm sorry.
Well, that's what I mean, you always interrupt and say, hurry up!
Okay, that means... At this point, gang, what can I tell you? Jill and Joe have 125, Claire and Skoy have 125, Betty and Ellen have $200, and our time is up. That means the blue section wins it for Betty and Ellen. Talking about coming from behind. We'll be back in a moment after this word to tell you what happened, okay? All right, we are back. Congratulations to our winners today, the blue section with Ellen and Betty. How about that? They won $200. $1,000 to that for a total of $1,200 for the blue section. Goodbye, everybody. We'll see you next time on Tattletales. Bert Convy says hello. Goodbye.